and he will do the components here and he will manufacture the product. Say for example, this is the computer manufacturing. So he will give the keyboards and the CPU, hard disk, and here we will manufacture as a computer, and this they will send to the distributors, and distributor will send to the retailers, and the retailer, like he will finally send to the customers. So this is we can call as a supply chain management. This is the way the demand will be flow, and this is the way the supply will be flow. This is like a typical supply chain management, like if you take any business. And now if you take like a global level companies, for example like MNCs or bigger companies, like a lot of plants are there, and they have a lot of distributors, and they have a lot of vendors, and they have a lot of retailers are there, and the products also might be, they have a lot of products are there. So to integrate all these things, like they need a effective software. So to integrate all those things and to run the business, to integrate all these components, they need a one effective software. So for that one, like in the market SCM softwares are available, and SAP A2O is the market leader for that one. Like it is a 70% of the business is occupied by SAP A2O. And other than SAP, Oracle and I2 and Ramkey Info, like that other softwares also there. And we will see why SAP is the market leader into the coming slides also. And the importance of the supply chain management is, now the market is throughput computation. So like here, if you manage the effective supply chain, like here indirectly it will increase your profits. So how, if you manage the, how the profits is depends upon the supply chain management. I will tell one example. For example, here the customer is like using 100 units per month. Like take some product, product X is using 100 units per month. So what I will do, if I am using 100 units per month, so if for next month, if my retailer will be delayed, so I will struggle for the product. So what I will do, my real requirement is 100, so I will give a order 150. The retailer will also think the same thing. One minute. Things will be covered, like what is the supply chain management and what is the supply chain solutions in APO and what is the APO in SAP SCM and high level APO business process and supply chain execution and planning and what are the modules are there in APO, how it is integrated with other systems and question and answer. These will be covered in our.
Yeah, I sent an IM. Did you see that one? Did you, are you going to take off ATP check as well as PPDF?
No, actually in APO, like normally how the requirement will be there, like they will ask you like only demand planning or supplementary planning, like module wise. It's not like one APO consultant should have the work experience in all the modules.
Okay, and there is one more also, SOP, sales and operation planning.
Yeah, that is in R3PP.
Oh, R3PP, not in APO. Yeah.
No. So, oh, okay. What we are doing, like we are giving a training on DP plus SNP plus SIP, so that like compared to others, we are into the good position in the job, right?
Okay. I mean, once you are done, I mean, can you send me an email what will be the teaching you will be teaching and the documentation?
Yeah, yeah. 70, okay, the end user, like he will get a talk from the retailer and he will get from the distributor and he will get from the manufacturer and he will get from the supplier, like that. So this is the demand flow and this is the supply flow. So if you take the
demand is reverse. Demand is reverse, supply is from back to
forth. Yes, yes.
Okay.
So, like if you take any like global companies or any bigger companies, like a lot of plants and a lot of distribution centers and a lot of vendors and a lot of customers are there. So to effectively integrate all those things, to effectively integrate all our supply chain, like we need an effective software. So that software is providing by SAP, Oracle, Ramki, i2 and Microsoft, like so many companies are there, but SAP is the market leader and having the 70% of the market share.
Mm-hmm.
And why we need effective software for the supply chain management? Why, if I have not integrated properly, what will be happen? So here I will explain with one example, that like a bullet method. Say for example, the user is required 100 units per month. So he will keep, if retailer will not give on-time delivery, so better I will keep a 50 extra stock and he will give 150 order here. And he will think the same thing and he will give the 200 order. And the manufacturer will give 250. And finally it will come to the 300. So if we have the proper communication entire your supply chain, so you need not to maintain like a unnecessary inventory. It means here the real demand is 100, but coming to the supplier it is like a 300. So here no need to maintain this inventory, like a 200 extra inventory, and we can save a lot of cost for the storage area also. So that is the reason to have the proper communication in your network, like in your supply chain management, we need to run one software. So that is the need of the APO. In the supply chain management, SAP supply chain management, we have these are the modules. Like APO is one module, and extended warehouse is another module, and SNC, supply network and collaboration, and this is another module. Earlier we can call as the ICH, inventory collaboration hub, and the transportation management and the event management and SAP, like remaining modules like that. We have the different modules are there in the SCM. APO is one module, and again APO having the different modules like a sub modules like a demand planning, supply network planning, production planning and detailed scheduling, global available to promise, and transportation planning and waiting scheduling.
If you so take, we are going to learn only two in that, right? So we will be learning only demand planning and supply network, right?
Yeah. Actually, if you take 100 projects, like almost 70 to 80% of projects have the demand planning and scheduling, and 30 to 40 have the PPDS, and 10% is the ZATP and 5% is PPVS. That okay. is the share. And if you see for the job requirement also, 80% jobs posted on the DP and SNP.
And are we going to deal with SNC also, supply network collaboration?
No. Only we are teaching demand planning, supply network planning, and
Okay.
And APO having the inbuilt BW server, so we will give the overview and we will show into the system for BW for 2-3 hours.
For report.
And here we can see individually what is the module will do in the APO. Example, the demand planning is basically for the generating of the statistical forecast. So what it will do, it will read the history, like the sales history data, and it will generate the statistical forecast. And supply network planning, it will do the planning. Planning means like we have the forecast values, so how much we can able to produce, what is the capacity of our machines, how many we can able to produce. So that will be taken care by the SNP, and how to distribute the stock to the DCs. So that planning will be done into the SNP. And the production planning and detailed scheduling, it will give the detailed level of the planning, like hourly based planning, how we will, like if I give the raw wheat and I will get a biscuits as a finished product. So in the machine, So what is the activities and what is the operations and how much time it will take, like all the calculations we can do into the production planning and detailed scheduling. And global available to promise, once you get the sales order, it will confirm the delivery, it will confirm the delivery date based on the EATP settings. And transportation planning and vehicle scheduling to optimize the transportation loads and minimize the transportation cost. And there is another topic like LX, like any exceptional things in the system, so it will trigger a message. Like any errors in the system, it will trigger a message to the business users. And here you can see the high level business process, like demand planning, doing the forecasting, SMP, customer planning, and PPDS, land order, deployment, like to distribute the stock and the transport. Finally, we will transport the stock to the plant to DC. So here the advantage of the APO is like we can do the planning at a global level. For example, if any company have the business Asia Pacific and Europe region and North America region, like it will integrate all the plant DCs across the globe. Across the globe, all the plants and the DCs, it will integrate and it will do the planning. And all the global level results you can see at one screen. So that is the greatness of this SAP APO. And this is the reason SAP APO got success in the market. No other tool cannot do this much of supporting for global level business. It is possible with only APO. And here we can see the difference between the SAP ECC system and SAP APO system. APO system is meant for planning and ECC system is meant for the execution. Say for example, sales order creation, giving the delivery and creating the invoice. So all these executions will do in ECC system. Based on this execution data, here we can do the planning. It means like since 2 years we are selling product A. So I will read the data here and here I will generate the forecast. Okay, since 2 years we are selling this much quantity. So for next 2 years we can sell this much quantity. So the planning we can do into the APO system. So once we did the planning in the APO system, we will send to the R3 system. And here they will take care of the manufacturing. Okay, next month we will sell 100 products. So we have to do the plan, like we need to manufacture 100 products. So based on this planning results, like here whatever the past data is there, so it will come to the here the APO. We will do the planning for the future and again we will send to here. So based on this planning results, here they will go for the execution. Clear?
Yeah.
Clear?
So we will be working on two systems, right?
Yeah. Yes. Yes. Like both are the separate box. Like how you are differently logging into the SNC, same thing like in APO also, like R3 and APO both are the different servers. Any question, Raja?
No, that's okay, good.
Srinivas?
No, sir.
Jia?
No, sir.
So here, now I'm talking like here we have the data and I am sending to here and I am planning here and again I am sending there. So how we are doing? Based on the interface, that is the core interface, CIF. ECC is the SAP system and APO is the SAP system. So to integrate these two systems, SAP is given standard integration, that is like a core interface. So based on this core interface, we can exchange the data from here to here and here to here. And in our course, like we will throw everything into the system, how the data is going and how the data is sharing from here to here and there to here, like that. Everything
we will showing, you'll be showing the configuration also in that?
Yes, yes, yes. We will give the entire configuration.
Okay.
And we will give the entire configuration and we will give the document also, like a step by step document. These are the features and the key benefits of the demand planning. Basically, the demand planning is for the statistical forecast generation. Other than, there is a lot of functionality supporting the demand planning. And this is the, see, this is the screen, like we can call it the interactive planning screen. And here, in one screen, you can access entire data. Like I want to see one product details, you can see here. And if you want to see one country data, you can see here. And if you want to see one regional, like Asia Pacific level data, you can see. And across the global level data also, we can see. Like, and the sales manager can access the data, regional manager can access the data, and the CEO of the company also can access the data, like at all the levels, like lowest level and the highest level. Like you can take product level and you can take any location level. Like that, everything we can access at one screen. So this is the beauty of APO. And the demand planning, other than the statistical forecast, there is a other functionalities like aggregation, disaggregation. Like to see the data, it's the aggregation. To see the data, it's that is the disaggregation. And the life cycle planning and the seasonality, like so many functionalities are there. So those will be supported by the demand planning. So basically, if you use the demand planning and if you generate the forecast, you will get accurate forecast values. So here SAP is giving a lot of formulas are there. So by using the formulas, we can calculate and we can get a quality forecast results. Otherwise, users normally they will use the Excel sheets to generate a forecast values. So there, whatever they do the forecast, it will be maximum will be supported to the real time results 70%. But using the demand planning tool, your results will be like a match to 90% or 90% plus to the real values. And supply network planning, for example, if we have the plants at different locations, so to integrate all the plants, you can do the cross plant planning also. Same thing like a distribution centers also. Like if you have the different regions distribution center, you can access all the data and you can do the planning like a central level. So that is the advantage of the SNP. And it is mainly integrated with the purchasing, manufacturing and the distribution and the transportation. And in SNP, SAP is giving the different type of the planning engines. Like I want to do the planning based on the cost. So we have the option to run the optimizer. I want to do the planning based on the my capacity of the resource. So we can run the CTM. If you want to run the rough cut plan, like infinite planning, we can run the heuristic. Like that SAP is giving the different planning engines to satisfy all the business needs. So using this SNP, we can reduce the inventory levels and we have the visibility overall the supply chain and optimize the planning result and it will improve the customer services. And the next is the PPDS. PPDS, by implementing the PPDS, for example, to manufacture one product, like a one product line is there. One production line is there. In that production line, there is so many operations are there. Say for example, if you take simple example like a wheat, like I will give the wheat and end of the mission I will get as a biscuits. So first it will clean the wheat, then it will dry the wheat, and then it will make it as a powder, then it will add as a sugar, then it will add as a water. So then it will boil it, and finally it will make it as a biscuit, and if you want it will add the cream, then it will pack it. Like this it will have the different operations. So like for lot of products and a lot of machines are there in organization, so how we need to plan, how much I need to produce and what I need to produce. So all those things by running the PPDS plan, we will get a detailed level of results. The system will give the results, like using this machine you can able to produce this much. If you want to produce extra, how many hours you need to run, how much labor it is real, it is required, how much raw material you required, like everything is calculated by the system. And we can, using this PPDS, we can run the plan like hourly based also. Like it will give the planning results based on the hour by hour. So this hour you have to do this one, and next hour you need to do this one. Like that hourly level planning it will give. So it means it will not waste single hour also in the organization. So that much effective level we can use our resources. And the next VATP, like if you get any sales order, it will check the stock is there or not. If stock is there, otherwise I will give another example. Like I want to buy a Dell laptop. So normally if you want to buy a Dell laptop, what we will do, we will go to the Dell website and we will choose the what are the model we require, and we will make the order. When you are making the order, it will give the delivery date. For example, today 29th, so it will say December 5th the delivery date. How it is giving the delivery date? Because of the GATP. And imagine if Dell laptop in the Dell website, like per minute how many is giving the orders, or per hour how many giving the orders across the global level. So how system automatically is giving the delivery dates? Because of it is running with GATP. It will check stock is there and how much time it will do that, it will take the delivery, or like how much time it will take the producing the laptop. So everything it will be checked, and it will run the PPDS plan, and it will take the confirmed planned order, and it will give the delivery date. Like this system automatically did everything. So here, because of this one, Delhi is not maintaining any retailer shop, any outlets, nothing. Just online, you can give the order, total system will plan it, and it will give the laptop to you. So because of the supply chain management, effectively maintaining the Dell got success, and now they are competing the HP and IBM. After Dell got success in the supply chain management, like everybody realizing, and now they want to go for the supply chain management softwares. That is the reason APO having the demand. After you paid, then only Dell will give the order to the vendors to get a components, like whatever the components they require to manufacture a laptop. After getting the money from you, then only they will pay to the vendors and they will get the components, they will assemble it as a laptop, and then they will give the delivery. Zero inventory. They are not maintaining single raw material in their locations. They don't have any storage locations because of running the effective supply chain management software. And transportation planning and vehicle scheduling. This module is specifically for the who are having the more fleet and complicated logistics. So for them it is useful, but in India I can say only below 10 projects are running with TPVS module. Only below 10 projects are running with TPVS. So here we have less opportunities. And the VMI scenario also supported by the APO, it will integrate it to the customer systems, and directly we can create orders into the customer system.
Means this is vendor managed inventory, means the vendor is keeping the product in our warehouse, right?
Hello?
The VMI, vendor managed inventory.
Yeah,
That is, the vendor is keeping the product in our premises, right?
Like what we can do, we have the integration with the vendor systems, and we can access their inventory, and based on the demand, we can create directly like a purchase to the vendor systems.
Okay.
And alerts monitor, like any exceptional things are there in the system, in the APO, we have the option to raise an alert. Say for example, in one client place, 1,000 products are there. In the 1,000 products, only 2 products having the negative values for the forecast. Normally, forecast should be always positive value. For example, only 2 products have the negative values. So, if there is no information, then what business users have to do? They have to check product by product. So, if they check product by product for 1,000 products, it will take 1 day. But based on this alert configuration, it will trigger a message like these 2 products having a negative forecast. So directly the user will go and check the products and they can correct the data. So for that one, it will take only 2 minutes. Like based on this one, it will save a lot of time bits to the users. And like any machine is overloaded, so any machine is overloaded, it will trigger a message so that we can go, we can do the capacity leveling for that machine. Like that, for all those things we can create an Alex. So any exceptional things in the system, it will raise a message, and directly we can go and we can check that error, like instead of checking entire things in the system. And this also we will do in our configuration, like in our practice.
Okay.
And these are the example screens of APO. Like you can see, if you select a location like Barcelona, Spain, and you can see how much forecast for week 49, week 50, what is the sales address having, like that everything we can get in the details. If I load a product A, it will show product A how much forecast is there. Like I can see monthly, I can see weekly, I can see the day level data also at one screen. And this is the latest server architecture of SAP SCM, and now it is running on 7, and we are providing the server also SCM 7 server. And here the database name is the Live Cache, and optimizer server is integrated for optimizer and geocoding, and it is connecting to the ECC system via STIF core interface. And these are the interfaces. Like in APO, we can connect ECC system, BW system, CRM, PLM, like that we can connect any system, any legacy system. If it is a standard ECC system, the interface is the core interface, and if any other system like ALE, BAPI, IDOPS, that is the integration part. And Live Cache is the database for APO, and the APO having the inbuilt cubes, like that is the BW, and ILAG server will run the optimizer. So this is the integration part.
And everywhere is the ILAG server?
Yeah, only ILAG server is using for the optimizer. To run an optimizer in SNP and PPDS, we need to use the ILAG server. And these are the some of the pain points, like a forecast quality not good, and maintaining excess inventory, and the lack of visibility of the supply chain, like capacities are shortage. So for all these issues, solution is the implementing of SAP APO. And we will go like a daily 1 hour classes, like daily 1 hour.